Can you describe yourself in 3 words?
No, I can't.
That's fair, that counts. Hi, Mike, how are you?
Hey, it's great to see you again.
Great to see you too. Mind if we take a little walk?
Yeah, please.
In 30 seconds or less, what do you do for work?
I lead a team of researchers and we study all kinds of unconventional intelligences embodied in, of course, brains, but also all kinds of non-brain tissue, cells, organs.
A few years ago, your lab got a lot of attention for building the world's first anthropod. What is an anthropod?
What it looks like is a little round creature. It self-assembles from adult human tracheal epithelial cells. It is also a platform that we can use for therapeutic biorobotics, so specifically patient-derived interventions that can be injected back into the body. You wouldn't need immune suppression.
Can you show me something awesome?
I can. I will show you
this. What is this guy?
So this is a toy. It's a stuffed planarian flatworm. Planaria have a number of interesting properties. First of all, if you chop them into pieces, so you can chop them this way, you can chop them this way, you can chop them this way. However you cut, the record is something like 275 pieces. If you chop them into pieces, every single piece regenerates to make a perfect little worm. So every piece knows exactly what the whole thing is supposed to look like, and they rebuild. That's the first thing. The second thing is planaria are smart, and you can train them. And if you train them and then you chop off their head, which contains their brain, you chop off their head, the tail will regrow a new head, and that new worm will remember the original training. So what they're telling you is that A, learned information is not stored entirely in the brain, it is somehow distributed somewhere else, and B, it is imprinted onto the new brain as it develops.
So the last few questions are easier and more rapid fire. Are you an introvert or an extrovert?
Introvert.
What keeps you up at night?
The dozens of emails I get every day from people in the most horrific medical circumstances. What keeps me up at night is that the research community is not going to be able to make the radical advances that are needed to actually to resolve these things once and for all.
And finally, last question, what accomplishment are you most proud of?
We have been able to, in my group, to really span the full spectrum from really deep questions in the philosophy of mind to specific practical applications that are going to impact patients. And so that's the thing I'm most happy with.
Those are all the questions we had today, Mike. Thanks so much for your time.
Yeah, thanks so much for being here with me. It was great to see you again.
You too, and we'll let you get back to your philosophical walk.
Bye, see you.